Hello and welcome to Fix My City on Asake Online. My name is Lesley Moyo. In this program, we discuss service delivery issues that affect the city of Bulawayo. Earlier this month, during the full council meeting, the Bulawayo City Mayor David Coulthard announced that the City Council had taken a decision to unbundle the engineering services department, separating water and sanitation services to create a standalone water utility. He says that this is meant to try and address the water challenges that affect the City Council and to improve in terms of efficiency in delivering quality services to the residents of the city. So we took this matter to the residents of Bulawayo to find out what they think about this decision that has been taken by the local authority. Also hearing that the local authority is working with a Dutch company that will help in terms of transitioning from this department to form a new department. We also are hearing that they've also appointed a transition manager to assist in this process. So we're going to find out from the residents themselves what they think. But before we hear from the residents, let's hear from the city of Bulawayo Mayor David Coulthard actually explaining how this process came about.
The broad resolution that we have to establish a water authority. And yesterday I was privileged to meet with engineer Dube, the water distribution engineer, and the person who has been appointed as the project manager for the establishment of the authority. And I was advised yesterday that the intention is to have the authority established by December 2025. The relevance of this to this debate is that for the authority to become self-sufficient and efficient, it and us are going to have to address this.
This is what the mayor of Bulawayo said during this month's full council meeting. Now we speak to residents from various wards in Bulawayo who say or who input into this particular decision, telling us what they think about it. And we also speak to the Bulawayo Progressive Residents Association, who also give us their input into this decision that the local authority has taken.
Tina njenge zakhamizi into esizwayo elibuya lizositela yona besexpecta yona city council ngokwayo is a service provider yethu njengezakhamizi izositshela isichazisele ukuthi iwenzelani khonoku isizathu sangkhona kuyini sizatholani sincedise kanjani ngakho khonoku kona lawo kubasiza kanjani ukuthi besinike service delivery through that decision. So nxa sokuphonga ukubuya kuyinto esisizwa ukuthi siyamukele siyamukeliswa kuyini asikwazi. So angake sisho ukuthi singithi siyayemukela thina singakwazi isizathu sangkhona sizayemukela kathi kule impact ezasilimaza phambili.
Siyabe sikhayelela ukuthi kube le consultation first. Bebe yibo abantu ababuya bezoyithula. Siyakuzwa vele kuma social medias lapho ukuthi kuthiwa sokuseparethwa i-sewer and water. So isiyaba i-department ezimele yodwa from i-BCC. But asikwazi ukuthi isizathu sakho yikuyini kwenzelwane. Kusuwa siyabe sikhangele sithi yebo engxenye yokusuwa sokuzasincedisa. Sike siphume ukuhlala emaxhaphozini. Kodwa emanzini, I don't know ukuthi i-solution yakhona izaphathisa ngapi ngoba manzi phela into kaNkulunkulu. Angikwazi ukuthi bona kuyabe sokuyasiphathisa ngapi khonapho.
Likhulume nge-consultation ukuthi mhlawumbe i-council ibingazange ifinyelele ezakhamizini. Ibazise-ke nge-decision le abasethe bayithatha. I-consultation iqakatheke kangakanani nxa sikhayeleke idolobho lakoBulawayo lama-services mhlawumbe singathi i-city council iyawaletha-ke ezakhamizini.
Iqakatheke ukuthi yibo abamukela usizo from i-council. Njalo kumele bona i-council ibonisane lezakhamizi ukuthi hhayi badala sikwenza ngenxa ukuthi sikhangelele lokho labo abadala I decision making is not one sided. It should be from top to bottom or bottom to top. We share. Wenza ukuthi siphumele impumela ezancedisa both sides. So bona kungaba ukuthi sebezosifida back bengazange kubuye kuzothatha ukuthi thina sithini. Siyabe songani into yabo. Thina nxa sesikhathazeka sokusihlukumeza sihamba kuyo. Kodwa nxa kwakuyinto esasisuka singula sizonke nini. Bazaphinda bebuye back badala into leyana esayidisayida sisonke nini. Isihlupha ngendlela enje singathini ukuthi siphinde siyilungisise. But nxa sokubuya kungumntana wabo vele osezelwe segoqelwe engaze efe siyathi ngcwabanini.
Into engiyikhangelele kakhulu eqakathekileyo i-council ukuze ibe khona yithi izakhamisi ngoba i-council ngaphandle kwethu akulanto engayenza ukuze ifunctione kumele ukuthi kube khona thina so nxa thina ingasasiconcede siplana ihodwa isifuna ukuletha izinto kithi kusuka kusindi
njalo nxa sikhangele ukuthi idolobha lethu vele le problem yamanzi okweminyaka leminyaka nxa bona besithi I department le izayenza ukuthi ama decisions abawenzayo lokuthi mhlawumbe ba nxa besiyacela izimali zokuthi mhlawumbe kulungisise indaba yamanzi kuzaba lula kibo nxa so le department ekhangelene lamanzi lezinto zesuwa libona njani I decision yale sikhangele ukuthi mhlawumbe kungaletha ke utshintsho ekutholeni kwethu amanzi lamanye ama services
njengengcitshi bona sebe kubonile ukuthi kukhona okuzayenza kube kuhle phela kungaba kuhle kubo kube nzima kuzakhamisa so yikho siqhakathekisa ukuthi ngakube kwaba le consultation first ngoba bangabuya sebele le department yani US esisithengisela amanzi sibe sesikhala ngokuthi amanzi asedura ngoba asikwazi ukuthi i-department leyo nxa ibuya izasebenza njani ngoba thina besijayeleni umazayi ukuthi uyathumela ama-meter readers abesethumela ama-statements so nxa sokungokunye asikwazi whether ama-statements lawana amanzi asezaseparatwa from ama-rates we don't know yikho besikhala ngokuthi ngakube le consultation
to add on that bona babethi nxa bebuya nxa laphana befuna i-budget approval kithi besibonisa ukuthi na ama-coffers abangenelana nxa kuyikuthi ku-health sokule problem bafisha from ku-housing nxa ku-housing sokule problem bafisha from ku-health nxa ngaphi ngaphi so khathi esinxa sokuzimele kodwa kuze leneliseka yini ukuthi sokule problem i-water iyefisha ngaphi ngaphi yona sokuyi-department esizimeleyo
sesigqiba ke interview I think engafuna ukukuza kini ukuthi ubaba kwathinta kakhulu ngokuthi mhlawumbe amanzi angabuya ke ese into engiyakhona isiphezulu yiphi mhlawumbe umbiko umbono elilayo elingawuletha ku city council ukuthi nje loba nje sebevele baqalisa into yabo kodwa kuyini ke abangakwenza ukuthi mhlawumbe ozaphathisa lana izakhamizi sikhalele ukuthi ekutholeni kwethu amanzi lamanye ama services edolobheni
nxa ukuthi bakhangelele ukuthi basebenza ama water meters hayi izakhamizi ngeke zinilise ngoba amanzi esintwini awancitshwana imagine ke mina sengile water meter ngithenge ama liters amangaka for a month umakhelwane wami useswela amanzi ngingamnika ngoba mina ngiyabe sengikhangelele i-cash yami ukuthi isisebenze so kumele iyegcina la so nxa umakhelwane wami ezocela amanzi sokuyi-extended family so I think ubuntu bethu khonapho buyabe sebuphuma buyabe sebuphuma lobudlelwane bethu buyabe vele sebuphuma ngoba nxa sokuthengwa amanzi sijayele ukunathisana lawe kunje ungathi uqeda lapho uthi ngicela linathise amanzi ngiwathengile ngiyasitsho ukuthi nxa ngingamnika isigoup lesi it was going to push me for a week nxa sokule-extended mouth is something else
sengezelele futhi khona bo okunye okumele bakunanzelele ilizwe leli ligcwele abantu abangasebenziyo siyabe singathandi ukuthi sibone izakhamizi kuvele kubunzima ezibuthweleyo zibuye zetheswe obunye ubunzima ngoba nxa kungabuya kube yinto ye-cash cash power na le water cash power. Boninga nuga besugu ya sinda kaku. Ngoba uko kathesi ngikhuluma nje kulezindlu ezivalelwa amanzi ezile 3 months ezilokho ezingakavula amanzi eziphila ngamanzi ayebhola so bona ababantu bebekutshela ukuthi amanzi ayebhola ngaze ngwanathe kangkhulu abese sithi kulabo abale tap water mhlane buyile edi ngicela ukuyipheyili nje ukuthi nithola ukunatha then nxa sokuyi cash power umlwane umuntu vele kasena ukucela amanzi ngoba ungakhangela kathesi izindlu zonke izigubhu ngamapheyili abantu bagcina amanzi ezindlini. So angazi nxa kungaba le solution ukuthi sebebone izinyo indlela. It's all right phela kuvele kumele nxa singabantu siphumelele. Singahlalisi kuzinga elilodo. But nxa kuyinto eyikuthi iza benefit ama residents, they are welcome to bring it on board. But nxa kuyinto ezaletha iburden futhi sibone ngani mbona ingani yona icouncil uye yabi siyachona icwili siyaphansi. Ngoba bayihlile ukubhadala okwakathesi pho sokunjalo bayakuthe sesiyagebha imithombo phela etown
and sesiyigebha imithombo sokuyi-health hazard sokungeyinye futhi impact kuzakhamizi sokungolunye udubo kuyo ikhansili sokuyudubo kugovernment ngoba sokumele bemanage ama-waterborne diseases lana futhi is another expense njalo futhi khonokho nxa bekwenza intengo yangikhona nxa iyabe iphansi bona okwamanje kuyikhonokho isystem esebenzayo baye bekhala ukuthi nana akula imithi bahamba nebhadala liphosele khonokho elilakho ukuze kuthenge imithi ukuze kwenziwe this and that then what more nxa abantu baya sebehlezi sebethulezwi esethenana imithi yami kumbe engazomvalelwa azithenganga amanzi senza phila ngesifula senza phila ngesiborane then what next idorobho lonke lingathi hayi thina sizazihlalela nje singasathengi lawo manzi sesiphila ngakhona ngendlela nale siphila ngayo khathesi kule water shortage then what happens to the council
mina igama lami ngundaba ngoma ngimele inhlanganiso yeBulawayo Progressive Residents Association ngingu-chairperson ka ward 16 igoqela iluveve legwaba
sizo ukuthi i-city council isi-separate engineering services department iyebo igoqela amanzi omgwaqo le town planning bese senza ke department ezimele yodwa ezabikhangeleke amanzi lesu lina njengezakhamizi likubona njani i-decision yale
okay njengezakhamizi amanzi lesuwa bekungamelanga bekuhlanganise amanzi bekumele amehodwa xa kukuthi befuna belokhu ze begxile kakhulu endaweni yani eyamanzi eyamanzi bekumele vele njani izimele yodwa ingahlangani lani le department yani yesuwa
indaba bekumele kubenza
ngikutsho ngesizathu sokuthi singakhangela most of okuhamba khona ama-pipes elokhuzeni amanzi aklino kunatha yikho lizathola khona futhi ukuthi amanye ama-pipes esuwa anjani atuzeduze njalo lanxa amanzi lana amasokisiwa lama-blockages egeleza ayagelezela phezu kwani singathi ngama-hydrants lawa elokhuzeni wosesikhathi ngabe kule leak khona phana so amanzi lalakho kunjani ukungena so bekukuhle ukuthi ilokuzeni nxa ukuthi baye kohlukanisa abamanzi behle bezimile benjani bengamanzi othi nxa evele suka kuma damu esiya kuma reservoir kuma treatments laphana azihambele beyamanage evele njani sikuswa kuvele sele lokuzeni ye water kuphela
ngibuyela futhi kwaphana ke endabeni yamanzi sikhangele ukuthi vele uBulawayo ube lehlupho lamanzi okwesikhathi eside kusenzela khona lokho ukuthi mhlawumbe amadamu ethu awasagcina amanzi okwesikhathi eside lokuthi izulu njalo lisuka libe lilutshwane kweminye iminyaka obangela ukuthi izakhamizi zigcine seziswela ke amanzi okusebenzisa libona ngani kuzancedisa yini mhlawumbe kuzaphathisa ukuthi kube le department ethiling ikhangela amanzi sikhangelele ukuthi vele iBulawayo ibivele lohlupho lwamanzi kwesikhathi eside
ya uhlupho lwamanzi lukhona kodwa kule apart from amadamu ulenyama indlovu angathi yaqala ngaphumnyaka so utshengisela ukuthi khona ngale nyama indlovu ungabe kukhona okusilelayo ngoba kusikhangelele khona ukuthi ngoba lalamanzi phela anti ngamanzi avela phansi so ngamanzi avela phansi bengathi bengezele linani lama bowls awo so ungasincedisa ngapi emanzini singasakhangelelanga ani avela emadamu sakwazi vele izulu belingani ngendlela enjani lokhu zilefanele kodwa silenye alternative inyama indlovu akhafa so ukuthi khona ngale ukuthi kona sebehambe isibanga singanani ngoba siyakhumbula ukuqala lesikhathi wake bagijigijima khona kungani ukukhona ukwenziwayo waphelela emoyeni so ukho singafundisi bekwazi kakhulu ukuthi khona le nyama indlovu kuyini okwenzakalayo ngoba lana phela amanzi apheli
njalo ke ezinyiza khamezi bezikhala ngokuthi akuzange kube le consultation lama residents lapho i city council lefike yaphawula khona ukuthi nase sifuna ukuthi senze so kwenzela ukuthi silungisise indaba yamanzi lama sibesuwa iqhakathe kangana nxa sikhale i consultation ukuthi ama residents lawo athole ithuba lokuthi afake ke imboni yawo sikhangeleke ama services alethwa yi city council
uqhakatheke kakhulu ukuthi benze ama consultations ngoba laphana lathi njengezakhamuzi uba la imbono esiba layo ngoba bona nxa bezenzela abakucabangayo sebeyenza sebeyasebekwethula sebenzile akukho fe kumele sithi meet halfway ngoba lathi sinje njengezakhamuzi kulembono esebe sinjani esebe silayo ukuthi singancedisana ukuthi ama services awanjani improve kodwa bona bengahlala phansi becaba ngaba ukucabangayo baku implement bese bebuya sebe sithi hayi thina sesi yenze lokho njengoba nathi ukuthi hayi ngoba thina sinje ngeke sivume ukuthi ngoba isikhathi esiningi amaswabe ehlula ukuthi banjani ama chokes la ukuthi balandelele ngikhuluma nginje kukhona phansi ngapha kuma 900 uqansa kusiyana okuthi izindlu ziyatshintshana almost every day ukulokhuza okay so ukututuma ilokhuzeni kwezinye isikhathi vele amabhathi abantu abasasebenzisi so then sebekuphinde bekuqathanise bekuhlanganisele lokhuzeni kaba consult izakhamisi
sesibona ukuthi asonto yokuqala ibula eveli lama business units azimele water singasikhalela labo ngwewe ukuthi akuseze kwenze mhlambe i-service iqinise sidura mhlambe abantu beqinise bethola amanzi adulayo ngenxa yokuthi le yabe si-unit la ezimele yodwa efuna ukuthi layo eke ithuthuke la iphakame
hayi akusoze kudure ngoba singakhangela even as it is okwakathesi zaba besuwa bala ma-stations aba singathi laba for instance kulalapha number 2 emabuthweni lapha lase senkulumane yoma lokuzenani abadila ngani ngelokuze ngeshuwa so in terms of abamanzi ngama plumbers avela njani ebevele engahlangani labantu besuka besizwe kwabo ama blockages benjani belozeni bebodwa then laba ukuthi ngathwa kule past kule pipe past leyo elokuzeni yamanzi clean kubuya ama plumbers from another lozen department bebevele bengahlangana and bebevele benjani into ezinjani ebezihlukena so ke izindlela bona they are trying to create kungani kukhona sifunde ukwenza ku service delivery akuda kuthwa kuzaba lokuzeni ukuthi kukhona ukuzayenza kube amanzi kami benjani i department eyodwa vele ikhangele okwani specifically okwamanzi and ngoba labona vele besuka siyabazi ukuthi ngakuthola bana babuya bezonjani bezohlukuza bayenza ama chokes abathini bathini I see babuya be attendeni i pipe yamanzi kanjani a clean okunathi so yikho bekwenzile bona wathi into esinjani ngoba bengakonsulta into athu zahlangana la All along, very Abamans, very Amaplumbers, Avelanjani, any department. Then you saw that putting in each department.
Umbuza Mokter on Skyler Conapa, Zabella Gugakulu consultation, Moti, a council, yeah, a car and Woody is a camis in my visa and town as the way of women. My institute decision as a camis versus Pendua Zikona as a consultant. Pinda futhi sezingazi low color mhlambe kwini elingakukhuzela inabantu ababukele ukuthi nqa kule mhlangano enjalo ke bazitholeke besiza kuze tilave imboni yabe ke izwakana
I council icatsha ngomuntu izakhamizi imhlangano bayithanda bakhuthele kakhulu kodwa bona nqa kulento abafuna ukuthi bayethule kumphakathi isikhathi sawo siba sincane so uma consultations inhlanganiso yethu ebuye progressive president association iyancedisana le council xa bebiza imhlanga befuna ihlale nani lama residents whereby okunye siyafaka kuma platforms kuma social media kuyenzwe lama flyers aza yenelisa ukuthi angene almost kuzindlu zonke ezabe zikhona ngapi ewadi so bona nxa besenza lutho isikhathi abasinika ilokhu zini siba sincane othi umuntu ahlathena uyabe vela enehlelo zakhe bona nxa belo lento futhi bayethule emphakathini uzakhamisa in terms of consultations kabathi benika abantu i time frame isikhathi ukuthi abantu balungiselele bekwazi ukuthi hayi ngelangelingaka kulo mhlangano omelana ngalokhu lalokhu lalokhu izakhamizi ziyasukuma
so i decision ye council to unbundle and separate i department yamanzi to make it a standalone lokuzen I think it's a good one it's long overdue actually because if you notice ukuthi indaba yamanzi kobulawayo we have always had a challenge of water and you find it very funny ukuthi every year for the past 10 years or so water has always been a priority number one according to the city council budget yakobulawayo and according to ama preferences awezakhamizi zakobulawayo but the water department is under the engineering department which makes it very difficult in the sense that when budgeting for amanzi you also need to cover the entire department of engineering. You can't cover water under one department and then you go and cover. So it is very much necessary to have a department yamanzi with its own director, with its own engineers and staff under the leadership of one person. So that maybe other options can be explored in terms of addressing the issue yamanzi, both in long and short term programs. You talk of Ulama pipelines that we have heard about, Okwaishangani. These things are stalling maybe because of a budget priority. Because imali nxa ibuya kuya prioritize ezinye izinto within a department. Kuthiwe akula equipment, akula zimota, and so on and so forth, akula personnel. And I priority CCA maybe ku HR, forgetting ukuthi amanzi lawo ayi priority enkulu kakhulu because US ngelawo. So it's important ukuthi I department yamanzi izimele yodwa ibe yifocus enkulu since ivele ihlala iyipriority number one kubudget yakobulawayo.
And what would you say is are the advantages of having that? Because now is this by a strategic business unit ezimele yodwa, it will also demand its own staff and maybe that could be costly even to ama residents who live then to foot either ama salaries or whatever. Else is needed to run that department. Won't that then come back and affect our residents in the sense that our services are coming at dinner? Come back to it.
I think yes, there could be ama challenges associated with the issue of staff having to increase staff and so on and so forth. But I think the city council on its own, as a local authority, needs to be proactive and creative in terms of raising a revenue. They must not always depend on our residents. I think Bulawayo City Council owns our properties, the city center. Some of the properties are lying idle. They are not being put into good use. Bulawayo City Council owns farms. they can be actually investing in those farms and creating alternative revenue streams. As a supporter, e-service delivery, we have always been told ukuthi amanye amalokishi eMpophoma were built ngemali zamabhawa. That was some kind of creativity to raise the revenue that was used to grow the city. So why can't we find other alternative means currently? Sibone ukuthi a viable, a business viable to raise the revenue, to support and supplement local ukukhitshwa izakhamizi. Because it does not work ukuthi the burden always of providing imali to the city council should always come from izakhamizi. We've got other industries that are not working. Why can't Bulawayo City Council find an alternative way to rent out those properties and make sure our properties lawana, they bring imali, revenue to the city council? I think our biggest challenge as a city is that we cry a lot we forget to think outside the box. We've experienced deindustrialization of our city, but I'm sure we can be creative enough to recapitalize and start creating indlela ezintsha zokuvuselela idorobho lethu ukwenzela ukuthi sithole imali yokuvuselela or ukwenza izinto zisebenze edorobheni lakoBulawayo. As it is, we read kuma newspaper kuthiwa izesa disconnected ama tower lights across the entire city, and the city council is not saying a word about it. They're just quiet. And then you wonder, how do we move forward as a city?
I'm Claude Putin from Bulawayo Progressive Residents Association. I'm the programs manager there. Yeah. So in terms of our take as Bulawayo, in terms of the local authority creating a separate entity in terms of that, to look at specifically to water or the debunking of the engineering services is, we strongly believe in terms of consultation, such that they can actually unpack in terms of why, because before you create an entity, you need to explain to the responsible stakeholders in terms of what created that need, of why is there a need of the creation of that entity, what has failed, and what would this new entity bring about in terms of change, in terms of water supply, for instance, what will it change? So we believe that there was a need in terms of rapid consultation. If it was a matter of budgets, I believe that there are organizations that could have taken the initiative to say, let's roll out a program that will actually move around the city, getting different views in terms of what people really feel about the creation of this separate entity.
But what do you think it's for the good of the city, considering that the city has had water challenges for a long time?
It might not be, depending on how they roll out this whole program. As it is, there are a lot of missing details that we don't even know. For instance, like I said, what created the need of this? Is this genuinely to address the water problem, or are there any other hidden agendas? You see, when there's lack of information, you start creating certain narratives. They might be true, they might not be true. So the reality is, there is need for transparency when you're carrying out such processes. We've heard a history whereby certain entities have been created by the local authority. And in terms of how profitable they are, there hasn't been any much accountability in terms of how much they are generating, how much they are cushioning our residents, because we believe that whatever entity that is created, there are calculations in terms of how much revenue that is going to be generated along those lines, and how much is it going to benefit the city, and how much is it go, and or how long is it going to go in terms of alleviating the water challenge that we have in the city.
Okay, you speak of transparency, you speak of missing information. We are hearing reports that already there's a transition manager that has been appointed, and that there's a Dutch company that the local authority is working with in this particular issue. How important or how key is transparency when it comes to these issues or to making these decisions? Because at the end of the day, this service goes back to the residents, who are the main beneficiaries of services provided by the local authority.
Yes, like I said, when there's lack of transparency, perceptions arise. And when perceptions arise, you find that we have a history in the city, which is not necessarily unique to us as Bulawayo. a history of corruption around issues to do with procurement. We have a history in the country that has to do in terms of ghost workers. We have a history that we know that whereby we've seen scenarios whereby that transition, who is going to be created where and who is going to be created where, what impact is it going to have in terms of rates? What impact is it? Are we going to be supplied with different statements that are related to water and other services that are offered by the local authority? So transparency is very key, because in terms of when you're speaking about development, we need to move together from the beginning up until the end, such that when it fails, we are able to say, we are able to reconvene and say, we missed it here, not that you missed it here. So it takes away that blame game. And also, it lays the foundation in terms of community ownership of some of these programs. Because you find that issues to do with vandalism, for instance, are related with things to do that communities do not own some of these projects. Communities do not feel that these projects are their projects. So they cannot guard some of the infrastructure that is actually built jealously, such that I'm cutting it like it's my own thing. Yeah.
But maybe let's go back to this water utility department that we are talking about. Was it necessary, though, maybe from your own standpoint, to have it standalone, to have it unbundled from maybe the roads infrastructure? We're talking about town planning and other services that were being provided under the engineering services department. Do you see it maybe as a step in the right direction in terms of addressing the water situation in the city?
This is twofold. It might be a step in the right direction, depending on how they implement it. Mm-hmm. We might be saying that they're actually creating a separate entity, or at least is going to be answerable to the same people that it was answerable to, which makes it unnecessary to actually create a separate entity when the same red tapes are still going to apply. Mm-hmm. So, but at the same time, we need to be prudent to say, and we need to be honest with ourselves to say, there are efforts that we need to do in terms of dealing with the water situation, because we are a dry city existence. We don't even know. I know that there are some areas that have literally gone for more than a month without receiving any drop of water. So creating that entity address such issues. It also goes back to saying, was there a need? Going back to saying, was there a need? And also goes back to saying, do communities feel like this is the best solution? Because you might think that solutions created in the boardroom are the best solutions, but you might find that communities out there have better alternative solutions that can actually address our water challenges. Was the report that was actually produced by in 2020 by the independent consultant even taken into account that we're actually losing about 60% of water before it even gets to the criterion? Were all those nitty gritties taken into account? So that's why I'm saying consultations are very key, and transparency in creating such entities is very key.
All right, thank you so much. And but as we wrap up our program, what would be your message to the City Council in terms of this particular decision, and maybe looking also at a service delivery that is due to residents?
I would say the Constitution, NTS1, each and every developmental blueprint that we have in the country speaks so loudly about devolution, speaks so loudly about consultation, the importance of consultation, the importance of involving communities in their own development. So we need to go back as a city and say, let's try to follow the legal frameworks that are there, the legal frameworks that actually guide local governance. Let's go back to basics. Come back to the people. Consult the people. There's no harm in terms of consulting the people. If it's an issue, like I said, if it's an issue of budgets, I know there are organizations such as our organization that are actually willing to support such initiative. There's no harm in actually coming back to the people. And it's not like it's going to cost you so much money. You might find that you might even have other organizations that are actually willing to chip in, that are willing. You can even have such gatherings, even in church gatherings. You see, let's go back to basics. Let's try to follow the Constitution. Let's try to do the basics. We have elected officials that we actually elected. We elected them to consult us, but were there any consultation with regards to this process? You might go to town halls, you might go to the chambers and feel like you're representing me, but you're not representing me because you have not consulted me at the end of the day. Let's go back to basics.
Let us know what you think about this decision by the Bulawayo City Council to unbundle the Engineering Services Department and creating a standalone water utility. You can do so as well by sending us what your thoughts are so that we also include them in our future programming. Do get in touch with us on the numbers that are appearing on the screen. Let's meet again in the next edition of Fix My City. My name is Lesley Moyo.